my hand, it's yours to hold. I give myself to you.
Here's my heart, please make it yours. I give my love to you.
We are two becoming one. Here I am, here's all of me. You have all that once was mine.
Today is the beginning of your life together, no longer yours, but each other. Joseph, your life is no longer yours, but it's Christy's. Christy, your life is no longer yours, it is Joseph. Everyone yearns for relationships. God made us for companionship, for community, for family, for friendships, and special of all, the relationship of husband and wife. You want to laugh, you want to play and talk, and be with someone who makes us feel loved and special. Because of this desire, Joseph and Christy, you come today stating you want this special relationship that God has made between husband and wife. You want to be married and build a home together based on God's love. Marriage is the blending of two unique personalities in all facets of life, form a new and wonderful relationship of building a home. The marriage and building a home is based on love. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 is the love chapter. Listen to these words. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not envy. It is not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, and these three remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love. Marriage is meant by God to be joyful and meaningful and marvelous. But however, marriage is not without its challenges and sometimes even struggles. There will be mountaintop experiences and many valley experiences, but let your love and commitment to each other not waver through this time. As you prepare to pledge your vows to each other, let me remind you that marriage made in heaven is a union of two lives, two hearts that beat as one. So welded together, they walk and work in love. As husband and wife should bear each other's burdens as well as share with each other's joy. Remember that you will have to cultivate the art of being considerate, loving, helpful, understanding, forgiving, and tender-hearted, and always putting the other one's needs first and holding each other up in love. Because of your love for one another, you both want to enter marriage by sharing of vows, rings, and a prayer blessing. Joseph, do you take Christy to be your wife before God and these witnesses to love, to protect, to provide for her rest of her life? Do you promise to stay by her side as her faithful husband in sickness and health, for better or for worse? Do you promise to be dependable, honest, and supportive? Do you promise to laugh with her, to comfort her in hard times, and rejoice in good times?
Say that. You do.
Repeat after me, but you can look to her. Christy, I promise to love you.
Christy, I promise to love you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
When life is easy and hard.
When life is easy and hard.
To be open and honest.
Be open and honest.
To grow in mind and spirit.
Grow in mind and spirit.
Above all to grow.
Above all to grow.
In Christ.
In Christ.
I promise to be there.
Promise to be there.
Every day for you.
Every day for you.
And love you.
And love you.
With the love of Christ.
With the love of Christ.
Do you take Joseph to be your husband before God and these witnesses to love and honor and to cherish him for the rest of your life? Do you promise to stay by his side as his faithful wife in sickness and health, for better or worse? Do you promise to be dependable, honest, and supportive? Do you promise to laugh with him, to comfort him in hard times, and rejoice in good times? Repeat after me. Joseph, I promise to you.
Joseph, I promise to you.
To love you.
To love you.
In good times and bad.
In good times and bad.
When life is easy and hard.
When life is easy and hard.
To be open and honest.
To be open and honest.
To grow in mind and spirit.
To grow in mind and spirit.
Above all.
Above all.
To grow in Christ.
To grow in Christ.
I promise to be everything.
I promise to be everything.
For you.
For you.
And love you.
And love you.
With the love of Christ.
With the love of Christ.
1 John chapter 4 says, "Dear friends, let us love one another. God has loved us." So they are going to exchange rings, and the rings is a symbol of unbroken circle of love. You both will give a ring to each other to display your commitment one to another. These rings are an outward symbol of an inward love and commitment to each other. As you see and wear these rings, let it be a reminder of the covenant of love you made this day. Joseph, place this on Christy's ring finger and repeat after me. I, Joseph, give this ring to you.
I, Joseph, give this ring to you.
As a reminder of my love.
As a reminder of my love.
My commitment to you.
My commitment to you.
As we build a home together.
As we build a home together.
I will love you.
I will love you.
With all my heart. Repeat after me. I, Christy, give this ring to you.
I, Christy, give this ring to you.
Of my love.
Of my love.
Commitment to you.
Commitment to you.
As we build a home together.
As we build a home together.
I love you with all my heart.
I love you with all my heart.
As I take you as my husband.
As I take you as my husband.
Joseph and Christy, you have demonstrated that your marriage is more than just joining of two lives. It is a unity with God as well. You have chosen to allow God to be the center of your marriage, woven to every aspect of it. Marriage is a companionship which involves mutual commitment and responsibility. You must cherish your spouse more than you cherish yourself. You are exhorted to dedicate your home to God, take God's word as your guide, and serve in His church. You are challenged to pray for one another individually and pray together as a couple and as a family, asking God to bless your journey as He knows best. Every day, love your Lord with all your heart and mind and soul. Have God at the center of your marriage and home. You are to comfort each other. Communicate with honesty and love every day. And every day, say, I love you, but just don't say it, show it. Every day, listen to each other, not just hear, but listen to each other. And every day, do something kind for one another. In other words, try to outdo each other in the kindness aspect. But as a minister unto the gospel of Jesus Christ, I pronounce you husband and wife. Joseph, you may kiss your bride.
Never been one to ask for help. I need a mountain moved and moving myself. I ain't the church pew regular, twice on Sunday quote you the scripture kind. I'm far from a preacher, but I'm a believer.